Hey, welcome back. So today's video is much longer. I think this is the longest video I've ever did, but a lot of y'all been talking about y'all want to see the full process of me doing my birthday nails. My birthday is on Sunday. Yes, the first Sunday of, you know, the month. But anyways, I'm going to start off first by doing the removal process. This is me removing like my Valentine nail. Now for me, I do have longer, my nails are outgrown, so I do turn my hand upside down so I can make sure I'm not cutting them. But in the end, you're going to see I basically cut the length of my nails off anyway, because sometimes I don't like to let my nails grow out all the way. I know it just feel weird, and plus doing soak-offs, I just don't be feeling like it's necessary. They always grow back or whatever. So, you know, I got this little gadget, a tool thing off, I think, Shein. It's really, really helpful when taking down, you know, the bulk of your nails. I think this also came from Shein. It's easy to use or whatever. All my stones and everything stayed on, y'all. I was using that Betty Cora. Y'all know that it's that glue thing that you use for gel-less nails, like, or you can do like how people do those chrome nails. I use that, and it works better than that McCart rhinestone glue thing. So I definitely recommend that, the solid gel glue thing. A lot of people know what I'm talking about. So yeah, starting off, I go ahead and chop everything that needs to be chopped off. And then I'm going to get into, you know, I think I have my drill on 25,000 RPMs just to get the process done quickly. Now, I will say you have to be careful when, like, if you don't know how to properly use an e-file, then I won't suggest having your all the way up at 25,000 RPMs. You're not putting pressure. You're just letting the drill bit do all the work. That's what I like to do. I'm not putting a whole lot of pressure or anything. Now, this is sped up. I'm not going this fast for the sake of this video and the sake of everybody low, you know, attention span. I did go ahead and speed this part up, but for the majority of this video, it's really like real time. Only thing that's like kind of sped up, like stuff like this, boring things are sped up, you know, application real time, me putting bling on real time, stuff like that. And so this drill bit, I think I got this. Now I know you can get this probably Shein, AliExpress, Temu, or whatever. I actually paid, I know I'm crazy, this was like early in my beginner stage, not beginner stage, probably like 2 years ago. I spent $15 on this drill bit. Like, I'm crazy, right? I got this from Brat Lab, something like that. I know a lot of y'all not gonna know what I'm talking about. I did see a video, probably last month or 2 months ago, of I Am Biscuit doing a unboxing of that, and I was like, oh, okay. I didn't know like people knew about her brand. You know, it's kind of cool seeing small businesses get more recognized as they grow or whatever. But anyway, that's beside the point. So I'm basically just drilling my nails off all the way down thin to where when I soak them, I don't have to go back in and continuously keep soaking. But then I realized that after I did all this hard work, guess what I didn't have? Acetone. So I was like, yeah. So basically, once I got everything down to like the thinnest I wanted it, I basically just, I don't recommend this. I did show it on camera, but still, I just basically popped them off. My nail beds are actually fine. They're not sore. They are, you know, they're a little damaged. You know, a little bit goes off of the nail plate when you just pop them off, but the acrylic was so thin that it wasn't like a huge, like substantial damage to the nail plate or whatever. So yeah, once that's done, I did the rest off camera. So these are what my natural nails look like. Y'all know, horrendous, crazy looking. So yeah, I'm just gonna cut my natural nails down, y'all, only because I just felt like I always keep my nails in a coffin shape or more like a stiletto, so my nails grow in that motion. I haven't really been doing square nails, so my natural nails grow the way that they are on the nail tips or whatever. So yeah, they were kind of growing a little iffy, so I cut them all off. So now I'm finna go ahead and, you know, get started with the prepping and everything. Like, this is like literally the start to end process of me doing my nails. You know, if you're new here, I'm not licensed or anything, but my nails, I didn't have no limp thing, none of that. I'm just going to show you what I do and what I love to do. So, you know, after you get done, soak off, whatever you do, if you want to pop your nails off, that's up to you. That's your hand. But don't let nobody, like, if you go to somebody that do that, if you're doing it yourself, that's your hand, that's your business. So first, after all that, I'm going to go in and push back my cuticles. And then I'm going to get into going in with this cuticle ball bit and basically just getting rid of the dead cuticle. And, you know, I don't cut my cuticles, well, epinicium or any of that. But still, I like to go ahead and, you know, get a clean, nice surface. It's not too much to do because I usually do this almost every time I want to keep my nails on for a long period of time. So, yeah. This year, like last year for my birthday, I did purple nails. I don't think I filmed that. Yeah, I didn't do that. Like, I wasn't big on doing YouTube last year. I had just started, I think, last year, yeah. But last year for my birthday, I think I did, like, a $600, like, only nail products. I probably, the least I spent was on $600 on a lot of stuff. I was shopping every which way. I'm not doing it this year. Like, I just realized that I spent a whole lot of unnecessary money on nail products, you know. But, yeah, I just feel like, why? But I do have things on my wish list that I do want to get. I probably get, you know, in a couple of years from now. I'm just really managing a lot of money better than what I've been doing because I am known for just buying stuff and not needing. So now I'm going to go in with the Santa band. Now, this is a used Santa band. This is my Santa band. This is what I use on myself. Now, if you go into shops and stuff, you see this, girl, just get out of, you know, because people, they don't never say, they always talk bad about, you know, like individual nail techs or people that like work from home in their own little shed suite or whatever you want to call it. But when y'all go to those, what you call them, like not Chinese, like Vietnamese shops or whatever, y'all don't never say nothing. But oh, let it be an independent nail tech, y'all got problems or whatever. But anyways, yeah. But one thing that's on definitely on my wish list is a new dust collector. I'm definitely gonna, I want to get the Kiara's guy. I don't care about what nobody say about, oh, this and that. A lot of controversy about them and their company. The products, it looks bomb. Everybody talks about it. And it looks like they got the best on the market. You know, by the time I get my, you know, lo and behold, now I'm probably going to come out with them. Because I'm like the first person they even told me to ask for a dust collector. They said they're working on it. But, you know, by the time they get through working on it, I'm been on got the Kiara's guy one. But anyways, yeah, so once I get through going in, doing all my cuticle work, prep work, right before I get to glue my tips on, this is the key, y'all. I'm gonna show y'all what I do. My nails do stay on now. I do change them up, frankly, but I do, the last that I had problems with a month, but my nails don't grow as fast or whatever. So now I'm finna go in with some dehydrated. This is before I put my glue my nail tips on, going with some dehydrator. So the nail tips can better adhere to my nail plate. No dust, debris, or none of that on there. Now, I know I'm talking a lot, but this is a long video. So a lot of people like when I talk. Some people just like listening to music. Y'all can probably get a little bit of everything. But for the most part, if you don't know, yes, I am turning 20 in a couple of days, depending on when I do this video. But yeah, depending on when y'all see this video. But yeah. Yes, I'm young. I'm probably just going to take myself out to eat, you know, by myself. Because usually I go with my family or whatever. Like, it's crazy because everybody's birthday 2 weeks apart, like, in my family. If it's not 2 weeks apart, it's a couple days, like, 2 or 3 days. But that's besides the point. Yes, y'all, I'm going long. Like, this is the Drake length. But anyway, like, these are the Drake length nails, but a little bit shorter, probably half of what it is. But anyways, let's get back to the nails. So yeah, I did have to double tip them because I wanted my nails to be long. I don't know. My dummy hand has always been longer than my non-dummy hand. I don't know why. I actually use my non-dummy hand more than I use my dummy hand. Why? I don't know. I'm just used to doing that. But yeah, for the most part, I'm doing a mixture of square and stiletto. I haven't done stiletto nails in so long. Not square nails in so long. Only because I ran out of the nail tips I used to have. And I haven't found any that's like long enough in length for me to use. Like, I'm done buying for, I don't care about the, let me tell y'all, buying for small business, they be trying to run you for your money too, because I'm not finna spend $18 on some box of nail tips when I can go on Shein, Temu, or AliExpress and get it for $5 or $6. Like, I get it, supporting people, but y'all not finna break my bank trying to get some nail tips. So yeah, y'all let me know what's a good, like, send me some links to some nail tips, like on Shein, AliExpress, Temu, that's like 3XL length or whatever. Like square, like I really want some square ones, coffin, and some long extreme stilettos, like 5X. That's what I really want. I haven't been able to find it, and I don't want to buy the wrong product and then, you know, I'm stuck with it. So right here, y'all, I realized that once after I got through gluing this nail, this the one on my index, and I checked the length of them, I was like, this looks weird. Come to find out, the index was so much shorter than all the other nails. Even the pinky was shorter than the rest of the nails. And I messed up. I forgot to cut my ring finger. My ring finger is the longest nail out of all of them. So look, I was like, at first I'm going to leave it alone. But I was like, no, nah, that look tacky as heck because all the nails different lengths. So I'm going to take this off and then go ahead and fix it or whatever. I'm just going to go ahead and get another tip and glue them together, then put on my nail. It's gonna look funny when I put it on, but you know, once you built your nail up and all that good stuff, it'll be, you know, back to normal and right. So anyways, excuse me, y'all hear background noise. The wind is actually blowing pretty hard. It's literally out there howling. But yeah, anyways, like, if you ever like mess up, all you can do is just, since I got a stiletto shape, I couldn't extend it from the end, so I had to take it all the way off and do it from the back. But yeah, like, if you cut your client nail too short or whatever, all you gotta do is get a tip and glue it on the end and then go about your day. It's pretty easy to add length, you know what I'm saying? But it's more time consuming, you know. It's easier to take away than add, but still at the same time, as long as you get it done, that's that. So next, what I like to do is, like, this step is necessary but not absolutely, like, it's not really necessary for real, but blending the tips. I've gone, like, when I do my nails, sometimes I blend them, sometimes I don't. Y'all let me know which one y'all do. For me, it does not matter. I get the same results every time when I'm doing my nails. So I really, this could save you some time, especially with people who, like, how can you do your nails in this amount of time? It still take me 4 hours to do this and that. Eliminate some of the unnecessary things that y'all are doing. Like, blending the whole entire nail tip or whatever and all this stuff. And, you know, how to blend the actual tip itself. You know, I guess so for the acrylic to flow better. Yeah, that helps, but it's so time-consuming that in the end, it doesn't matter if you blend or you don't. Like, I get it, a rough surface make the acrylic flow, you know, stick better, last longer. Yeah, but if you worry about your time and you taking too long, cut some of that unnecessary stuff out. So as you seen, like I just did, I put some more dehydrate on. Now if you don't like to use too much products on your nails or whatever, then don't do it. For me, these are mine, so I use as much dehydrate or whatever, chemicals or whatever, it depends. Now if I wasn't keeping all my nails on long as I am, I wouldn't do none of this stuff at all. So this is something new I've added to my prep game. It's changed tremendously, and this is the no lift nail primer. Now a lot of people I see use this so wrong and improperly. Actually, right here, I'm using absolutely too much myself. I've learned, like, when using this product, a little goes a long way. So if you have like a napkin, once you dip it in, take your napkin, dry it, like, really kind of like drying off, and just spray your nail. You absolutely have to wait until, like, for this to work and you get, you know, great retention. Let this product dry each layer. I only do two layers. I do two layers of this, and then I'm gonna do the Young Nails protein bun. I kind of figured that I had the protein bun since I started. So this has been like 3, almost 4 years now. And I know it's not performing like the way it is, like it's supposed to. Like, I think the time that's on the protein bun is like 12 months, or it might be 24. I know the way it's performing is not how it's supposed to. I probably need to go ahead and throw this out and just get a whole new bottle, but I'm only doing this myself. But yeah, I have noticed that before I started using the no-length primer, when I was just using the protein bun and then I think not polished primer, my nails wasn't lasting as long. But it's really probably the no-length that's making my nails last that long. But anyways, you know, I just let that dry. Each layer, gonna make sure you just let it fully dry before you go in with another coat or whatever. And then here's the next thing that, you know, it's really, really important. Once you get through and you let the, it dry and settle down a little bit, go in, like, straight away and go in and, what you call it? Yeah, the clear layer. Do a thin, very, very thin layer. This will help with your retention. You don't need, don't try to build the nail up. Just basically, like, paint on gel polish. That's how your clear layer should be. I don't know if y'all know this, but I am left-handed. But this whole video, I'm using my right hand. It may look like some people be like, I'm actually better using my non-dummy hand than my dummy hand. Probably because I take my time, you know. But yeah, just do this. Do a thin layer. Take your time. Girl, watching me do this is like I was born to use my right hand for real, for real. Like, let me find out my parents try to make me be left-handed. Like, but anyway, nah. I was actually struggling, y'all. This is too much right here of clear for my pinky nail itself. So I did try to, you know, swipe it all the way down. You only need a very, very tiny bead just to lock in that primer, you know, that good stuff. You know, because once you go on top of that and you seal your cuticles up, all that is going to look so flush, so clean, and whatever. So yeah, this is another tip. I see a lot of people, just some people don't do this clear layer, but for me, since I be doing colored acrylic glitter and all this, I need this clear layer. But if you're the type of person that only does like nude bases or whatever, I don't think you really need, yes you do, because once you get the drilling and filing, that clear layer is gonna let you know where to stop it. Like, so definitely put a clear layer down. Like, if you get the drilling, say you got one whole solid color, no clear layer at the bottom. Once you get the drilling, filing off, you're going to mess around and not know where to stop it. Because that clear layer lets you know, like, okay, we're getting close to our natural nail. Now it's time to, you know, put a pause on that. Now, what's tricky and what's dangerous to me, I did this before, is when I did a whole full clear nail. And I was like, I was trying to see, am I close? And I messed around and gave myself like a ring of fire. I was like, never again. Okay. So I just try to eyeball it. And I don't do full clear nails. Like, you know, back in the day, they used to do clear, put polish on top. Nah, baby. I don't do that no more. But yeah, as you can see, like I said, my index nail does look a little weird, but excuse me, you really have to just trust the process, okay, y'all? So let's get into some of these products that I'm using, okay? Because it's a lot. Right here, we got Bum Nail Snow Bum. This color right here is a custom acrylic. This is Bee Glitters March 17th, which is cute. You know, I was like, my birthday's in March. That's March 17th. But anyways, we got, what's her name? Bum Nails Line Wire. We got some A76 nails. I think that's nude, please. And also, you can use my discount code BREE10 to save when you shop A76. And then this is another one. It's a custom glow acrylic. And the clear I'm using that I definitely recommend is from Dream Nail Supply. Y'all already know I talk about her a lot. Her, A76, and Bum Nails. Like, the three main products I use in my videos. Of course, and the rest of them, you can't really purchase those, so I really don't talk about them. Well, they're either custom. So, start off with my thumb. I wanted a marble, but then I was like, I don't know. When I do my nails, I didn't have no inspo. I just go with the flow. I really feel like birthday nails, just like, especially when you do your own nails, I'm not the type to, you know, do what's already been done with all the other type of birthday nails. So now I was trying to decide, do I want to do silver or gold? I really should have went with silver, but I was thinking, like, you know how people do those money nails type of things, but I didn't want to do money nails. But, you know, Mardi Gras, you know, you got your gold, got your greens, got your purples and stuff like that. I was kind of going for that vibe. And also I was like, I've never done like green nails for real, but I think my last two, maybe three videos with green nails. So y'all let me know, because I haven't did my dummy hand yet, my non-dummy hand yet. What should I do for that? I'm thinking yellow and like, or maybe like blue and yellow, or just yellow period, or kind of do like, I don't know, haven't decided. That's gonna be shorter. Like I said, I usually do, I don't know, my right hand has always been shorter than my dominant hand. I function more like that. I've always done it the other way. I don't never keep my nails to the, you know, they're sisters, not twins type of vibes. You know, even though twins are sisters, but still, y'all know what I mean by that. So, yeah, for my thumbnail, I actually love the way this came out. I was going to do like a glitter ombre, but then I was like, nah, let's get some of this nude in there. For the most part, some like tips and tricks for doing your dominant hand is just take your time. Now, I also could have took the easy way out and used my press on nail stands and basically did the nails and then glued them on and then did the nail bed area or whatever I was gonna do. But I was like, I actually enjoy taking the time out and doing the long process. This nail set probably took 2 hours, but I took breaks in between. So once I got done with application, I let you know, harden up. I think I went 8 or whatever, came back, shaped and filed, took another break because I had to use the bathroom. And I do want to say, ladies, gentlemen, when you're doing nails, please at least get you a couple sips of water in or whatever. My cup was literally right beside me, so every time I got through one finger, I started sipping. Or once I got through with one full step, like application, drop me some water, you know, a snack here and there, whatever. Like, please take care of yourself when you're doing these nails, especially when people and service providers, they're doing 3-hour, 4-hour nail sets. You have back-to-back clients. Please take care of yourself, please. And also another tip, please, to save time, y'all, because I notice a lot of people don't care about application, but I do. Just keep your sides clean, especially when you're doing your dominant hand. Like, just keep your sides clean. It will save you so much time with shaping, because my hand feels weird using my own non-dominant hand trying to shape. So I'm just like, okay, I have to make sure this is the cleanest application ever. And usually, my nails always look better. Like, I think since we're so used to using our dominant hand that when we do application on the, you know, using it, it's like we just go with the flow because we know we can always clean it up later. But when we take our time more with using our non-dominant hand, y'all know what I'm saying? But yeah, my sets always come out better. But I'm really liking the way these come out. Watching myself, like, doing the process is different from actually watching yourself, especially when editing. Like, actually making the set come to life look so good. Like, if I was somebody else watching this, I would be sitting here enjoying this so much. This process just amazes me in general, because, you know, I love nails. So it's just that somebody who's not into nails probably be like, okay, skip through, what's next, she's taking too long. But someone who actually enjoys the craft of doing nails will know, like, this is euphoria for real. Like, oh my goodness. So yeah, I feel like I've talked a lot, so I'm probably gonna go ahead and let y'all enjoy a little bit of this. This is in real time, y'all, so everything is in real time. You know, so I'm gonna let y'all enjoy a couple more few minutes. You know, I'm put some music on, let y'all enjoy that, and I'll come back in if I got some more stuff to say. I'm finna go, you know, drink, you know, a little water or whatever, because I got a long way to go with editing this video. So yeah, enjoy this and I'll be back, y'all. Mm-hmm.
Eagerly, we await to be adopted as God's children, redeemed. By this hope, we have been saved. But who can praise God from the grave? So we will rise upon that day, glorifying your name above all names. I need him each moment. I have come to know the peace that he bestows deep down in my soul. In every moment, surrounded or alone, when no creation groans, I will sing a
step up, get some air now, let's go edge up, to some ice, but you'll be heavy in my mind, can you get the heck out, I need rest now, drop me one though, you so you, to the kid from pushing the best of me. I worry that I wasted the best of me. All your baby, you don't care. Sometimes when I be in no sense, it's just urgent. Tryna make some simple little change. Got me a war in my mind. Gotta let go of Wayne, think he was holding me. Choose the right, but it will pick up in front of me. Disappear if you live. Feeling like Jericho, feeling like Joe. When he lost his shit, gotta hold my own, my cross to bear alone. Now, ooh, way to deal, way to heal the food. No, you like that shit. Can't do it, baby, baby. Heavy on my empty mindset. It's just urgent. Gonna make some little change. Got me a war in my mind. Gotta let go of Wayne. Think he was holding me. Choose the right, but it will pick up in front of me. All the while, I'll wait my arm and see what it's like. Still wanna try, still believe in good days or sunny.
Look at her. Look at a woman, man. Look at her. That ain't my girl, that's my nigga. Catch me out on Ocean Drive with her. Catch me in the whip, ride with her. Sippin' something, bumpin' big, hypnotized with her. Pray you get that job in Tampa. That's only 4 hours away. Take a car, take a plane, baby, whichever is faster. Whichever one is in the hassle. Oh, damn, yeah, man. Never knew, no, I never knew that you be a freak and a friend too. Yeah, you into everything I'm into. I got something that I can lend you. A peace of mind, baby, come and get a peace of mind. Yeah. Say you gotta work from 3 to 9. I get you home by a decent time. Wait, your bed, you can sleep in mine. Yeah, let's make it happen, girl, I need some time. Speaking of time, who stopped it? That's the feeling that I get when we lock lips. I got the weed at the crib and the liquor too. I fuck your soul, I release in your spiritual. I be your muse, bring your easel and pencil soon. Here you go, you try and tease with them pictures. You could ride on me just like you ride the elliptical. She said I'm trying to keep it tight for my nigga. Girl, I like your last nigga, all I need is mental. You know I'll work you out, get you right with your physical. Always just another interlude. Asking all them questions, girl, you know I don't do interviews. It's pitiful that when I'm with them other bitches, I pretend it's you. You work at Kohl's, you in dental school. Wife and I, you folding clothes, cooking dinner too. Young chiller, girl, I'm known as Pen Griffey too. It's only right that I swing by and hit it too. First base, second base, third base. I'm trying to get you in your birthday. I know these other niggas thirsty, but please never entertain them, cause that would hurt me, you feel me? Yeah. I know you feel me. I know you feel me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Whoa, whoa.
All right, I am back. So I did want to come talk during this process, this nail, because this nails were definitely like a trust the process. You know, I know, Let me calm down because I'm breathing a little too hard. I know some companies make, like, this type of acrylic. Y'all don't know what I'm talking about, the foil acrylic. But I just felt like, why would I waste my money buying those when I got foil and I got clear, I can put it together. I know y'all see that part that's on my the right side hanging off. That once I shape that, it'll go away. That's just the nail tip that I use to extend it out or whatever. But yeah, I just felt like I gotta come to the realization that I can do a lot of stuff myself as far as product wise, like glitters or whatever, you know, just to save a nickel and dime here and there. It's like, blows my mind. I know y'all probably hear my window because the wind is like terribly blowing real, real bad. And I also want to talk about y'all. I might go live on Mondays and Wednesdays in the morning. Now, I know everybody and their mama going to be at work, but I still want to go because I've noticed you get a lot of engagement when going live and a lot of exposure. And I want to see what it's like to go live or whatever. But like I said, it's a big might, okay, y'all? No promises. Like I said, I don't have time to do it, so it's going to be in the morning. For me, I'm such a standard time, so you might see me on probably at 9 o'clock in the morning. Somewhere in the world, it'd be 10. Somewhere, it'd be goddamn 7 o'clock in the morning, whatever. But, yeah, just come in and say hi or whatever. I'm not really much of a talkative person when doing nails. I'll probably have music on. Now, I know YouTube don't play about music. I don't care about none of that. You know, I'm going to play it. I'm not here to make bitcoins or whatever. I know a lot of people, you know, making money on the side is good or whatever. But it's not like, I don't put my eggs in all the same basket type of thing. Like, if I was to be a content creator and making money off of, you know, creating content, it's not that deep for me. So I don't care about being copyrighted or whatever, unless it's to the point where I can lose my page. Now, that's different. But anyways, what was funny to me, because I was just thinking about it, mom was like, what you want for your birthday? I told her $20. She just looked at me like, yeah, $20. I'm turning 20. Just give me $20. Like, you know, I accept all forms of payment. You want to give me cash? You know, I Zelle, I got PayPal. I don't do Cash App or none of that crazy stuff because a lot of people be doing these crazy little chargebacks. So why? So Zelle and cash is my root. Like, those are only two forms of payments I be accepting, especially when doing business and stuff like that. Zelle, because once you send that money, baby, you can't get that back. Ain't no chargeback. Because I be seeing a lot of business horrors on TikTok about people doing chargeback 3 months later, 5 months later. I think that should be illegal. 3 months later, 5 months later, baby, as soon as something go wrong and I receive my package, I'm like, ma'am, what's this? Can you help me? Like, your problem should get resolved within a week. Not no 4 or 5 months later. But anyways, that's beside the point. But yeah, I was like, yeah, like, just think about it. If everybody in my family just give me $20, like, I could go and get me that Kiara Scott desk lid. Like, I got 5 sisters, okay, y'all? What's that? That's like $100. That's not $100. Is it $100? Yes, that's $100. I'm like, I'm a third there already. My parents, that's $40, okay? Maybe my grandma and granny might give me, you know, they might give me 15, like 10 here, there. Okay? And, like, yeah. The rest I can just buy myself, you know. So I'm basically only paying half the amount of money for the Kiara Scott desk lift. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah. I might get it next year for my birthday. Hopefully not possibly don't come out with theirs. And I see how that goes. We'll see. We'll see. But yeah, the dust collector I have is like trash. Now, I've tried, who is it? Is it McCart or is it I think it's McCart, you know, but it's not cordless. I want a cordless one. I think they got some new ones, but I'm just like, I need one that's going to be, is somebody cutting their grass? But anyways, I just need one that's going to do the thing. Like, that's the one that's like really best on market. I know some people say it's no difference or whatever, but baby, nobody else marketing theirs like, you know, how they doing it. But yeah, enough about that. And also, like, I be thinking about what I want is really what I need. Actually, I do need a dust collector. That's a necessity for me. But things that I want, like I said, I want some new brushes, acrylic brushes. I actually want nail tips. Do I need it? No, but I just want it. But I'm trying to see. I really don't even need anything. What I do need is monomer from Inner Couture. But like I said, y'all, I'm not finna pay that much money when I'm used to paying $99 for it. That gallon, but he's not selling it for that no more. Like, that promotion gone. I should have been stocked up when I had the chance. And I just keep looking. He having the 25% sale. So I'm like, no, I'm not waiting for no 25%. That's also, I want to try a scoop, y'all. But I don't want to waste my $20 if my parent, like my sisters or them, some, because I only got number 5 sisters, y'all. It's number girls. I don't want to waste my $20 on some scoops. Like, I'm scared. Like, I don't want to do that. Like, what if I get some stuff that I know I don't want? Then I'm going to have to do a giveaway. Then I'm going to have to waste my $20. Well, it's really $15 if you keep on having these $25 off sales. You know what I'm saying? But I know I'm rambling, but somebody's going to enjoy this, you know? It just feel like quality time and whatever. And plus, I want to talk during this nail because at first, I wasn't seeing the vision. But now, once these nails are done, I see the vision. And what I was going for, like, if these were money nails, they would have sold for real. But yeah, like, that's crazy. Now that I'm thinking about it, I'm probably gonna miss out, because I think he got super scoops now. Like, you pay $60, I want to try that, see what it is, what's it about. Like, I'm getting jealous watching all y'all unbox these Inner Couture scoops, and I'm just like, do I want it, do I don't want it? No. Be like, yeah, I want it, but I don't need it. So yeah, it's hard trying to balance out what you want and what you need. Like, what I really need, like I said, monomer, that dust collector, and I also need a new lamp. Like, not drying lamp, but the light, like, for filming. I wanted to try the little moonshade one, but I feel like the moonshade, I'm getting in the way of filming, so I'm like, nah. And I also seen, like, the little thing that's been going viral. It looks like one of those makeup, it's square. Y'all know what I'm talking about. A lot of y'all know what I'm talking about. Y'all probably seen the little light, the little selfie light thing. I want one of those, but I'm like, it's good for, like, filming long videos. So I'm like, whatever. But yeah, that's like three things. That's only three things I need. Usually when I do this stuff, I get things for myself. I don't like when people buy me stuff, because people tend to throw that stuff back in your face. I am a living witness of people doing that, and I just feel like you wasn't genuine in the first place when you did that crap. So yeah, like I said, y'all, I hope y'all really enjoying this video, this full process. Y'all let me know. This is the longest video I ever done, you know, editing wise and producing. We'll see how it turns out. Now, for me, I don't care about views or none of that crazy stuff. I did, I'll be doing much better what I'm doing now. So, do y'all see how long this ring finger is? All my nails were different length. Even when I tried to fix them in the beginning, they all was different length. And y'all can still see the number on this tip. That's how I forgot to cut it. And I knew once I had finished, I was like, okay, I'm going to drill this down. But then I was like, okay, nah, I'm just going to leave it like that, because I was getting lazy. But yeah, so for this nail, I wanted a glitter bottom. And also, I just want to use the products that I have. Like, I started off not being a glitter girl at all, but I bought so much glitter. I got 3 times the amount of glitter than I do regular acrylic or whatever. But that's besides the point. I'm coming to the realization that it's okay to use what you got. It's okay that nobody likes what you put out or produce. As long as you're happy with what you're doing, that's the thing. Like, you'll live a little bit longer. Just a little bit longer. If you start worrying about what people think about you and say about you and feel about you. I'm glad I made the change a couple months back to put myself first and not be underneath nobody's shadow and doing this and that. Because a couple months ago, I was not feeling like the person I know I was inside, hanging around with the wrong crowd or whatever. Like, you know, I'm good. That type of energy is not wanted or needed, and all it did brought nothing but chaos and drama. So, yeah, I'm naturally a person that stays to their self anyway, so it's okay. But, yeah, I was just, before I started this voice, so I was on TikTok. Y'all come to our TikTok so I can follow y'all, okay? Like, comment y'all TikTok so I can follow y'all or whatever. But I was just on TikTok, and I seen this thing where this girl and her best friend or something got in an argument, and her friend destroyed her whole last suite or whatever. That's why I don't play that. If she really was a genuine friend, which she wasn't, she wouldn't even have no ill intentions to do stuff like that. She probably was hating in the beginning. To begin with, she was not really a genuine friend. Because I don't care whatever happened, whatever. I would never fix my hands, my mouth, my feet, my arm, my leg, my eyeballs to do something that crazy. Especially somebody's business. Like, you went to her personal her place, a business, and destroyed her stuff. That's crazy. No, it's different if y'all two probably fought in a parking lot or at y'all home or something. Okay, y'all just destroying each other, not no personal property type of thing. Things should never got that deep to where you feel as though you need to go destroy your own best friend's stuff. That's crazy. But yeah, hopefully she gets it back on her feet or whatever. I think she started a wish listing. I'm probably going to check that out. I didn't see a link, so I'll probably have to go back, see if I can find her page and see if I can, like, get something off of there. But I also, I'd be so scared, because what if they scam me? Like, you know, I'd be scared to do a good deed and find out later, like, oh, they were just scamming to get some money or this and that. But, okay, I'm like, okay, money already spent. Let's go about that day. I really don't know why I used all these greens, because when I started umbraiding and blending them, they all looked like it was really one for real, for real. But I know I wanted my nails to glow in the dark a little bit. So, yeah. I am finna take a break of talking and let y'all enjoy this again. I do want to say that when y'all see me do my pinky, it gonna look like I was... Originally, I wanted to do a color block. But then I was like, it was kind of not looking ugly, so I decided to do an ombre. These ombres wasn't really doing the job for me because I really didn't want to do it. But I was like, yeah, I want to do it. Like, I couldn't make up my mind what I want to do. But yeah, sit back and enjoy these, and I'll be back, y'all, okay? I'll be back.
I know you feel me, yeah. Whoa, whoa. Girl, I know you feel me, yeah. So much to live for, true, baby. Let's not rush into it now. Let's not rush into it. When we get to it, we can give it all that we got.
Me, can't focus on me. Focus on me, baby, can you focus on me, baby, can you lazy and broke. Now we get this money, so I guess I can't complain. But I feel alone even when we're alone. And that don't cause a thing, but I don't want yours. Baby, I just want you to get up.
Thank you. step out. Get some in now, tiptoe edge out. To some iceberg, you'll be heavy in my mind. Can you get the heck out? Honey, rest now, got me bummed out. You, baby, baby, baby. Driving on my empty mind, shit. I try to keep from losing the best of me. I worry that I wasted the best of me. All your baby, you don't care. Sometimes I be a nuisance, it's just urgent. Trying to make some simple little change, got me a war in my mind. Gotta let go of Wayne, think he was holding me. Choose the right, but it will pick up in front of me. Disappear if you live. Feeling like Jericho, feeling like Joe, when he lost his shit. Gotta hold my own, my cross to bear a long night. Ooh, way to deal, way to heal the food. No, you like that shit. Can't prove it, baby, baby. Heavy on my empty mindset. It's just urgent. And I'm making some little change. Got me a war in my mind. Gotta let go of weight. If he was holding me to the right, but it will pick up in front of me.
Catch me out on Ocean Drive with her. Catch me in the whip ride with her. Sipping something, bumping big, hypnotized with her. Pray you get that job in Tampa. That's only 4 hours away. Take a car, take a plane, baby, whichever is faster. Whichever one is in a hassle. Oh, damn, yeah, man. Never knew, no, I never knew that you be a freak and a friend too. Yeah, you into everything I'm into. I got something that I can lend you. A peace of mind, baby. Come and get a peace of mind. Say you gotta work from 3 to 9. I get you home by a decent time. Wait, your bed, you can sleep in mine. Yeah, let's make it happen, girl. I need some time. Speaking of time, who stopped it? That's the feeling that I get when we lock lips. I got the weed at the crib and the liquor too. I fuck your soul, I release in your spiritual. I be your muse, bring your easel and pencil soon. Here you go, you try and tease with them pictures. You could ride on me just like you ride the elliptical. She said I'm tryna keep it tight for my nigga. Girl, I like your last nigga, all I need is mental. You know I'll work you out, get you right with your physical. Always just another interlude.
All right. Y'all see, we done. I think application took, I don't remember. I think it took, it literally took 7 minutes each nail. So y'all do the math. That's like 35 minutes. I will say probably took me 45 minutes just to do application, just to add a little bit more time, you know. But that's pretty decent. That's pretty good. Yeah, so now I'm finna go in. I'm basically just sealing my cuticles. This is a panel drill bit. I forgot what it's called. Can't think of the name. I'll try to link as much as possible. But if I don't link something, leave me a comment and I'll do it for y'all. So when I'm doing sealing my cuticles, I just do 12,000 RPMs. I don't do 5. 5 is too low. You really need, when you're trying to seal cuticles, you need to be doing anything more than 2,000 RPMs. That's just me. That's just my personal preference and experience. Every time I did lower than 10, it wasn't giving what it needed to do. You know what I'm saying? So yeah, for the most part, I only really use this drill bit to seal my cuticles. I don't try to buff out the nail or whatever. That's what my file really for or whatever. So I usually go in with my hand piece and then do a hand file. Y'all let me know which one y'all do first. So overall, shaping these nails was super, super easy. Application saved me a ton of filing or whatever. Like, application was pretty clean. I will say that off camera, I do feel my nails and make sure I'm getting everything, any lumps or bumps, I go back in and fill them with clear. I did do that off camera. That probably took like 2 minutes. Only nail I fixed was this nail I'm doing right here, my middle nail, and then my thumb, because I found, you know, it was a little lumpy or whatever. But yeah, for the most part, I'm just sealing my cuticles, and then we're going to get into some hand filing, y'all, and then we're going to get into the fun part.
Focus on me, baby. Can you focus on me? Lazy and broke. Now we get this money, so I guess I can't complain. But I feel alone even when we're alone. And that don't cause nothing, but I don't want you. Baby, I just want you to get up. Focus on me. Can you focus on me? Yeah. Baby, can you focus on me? Can you focus on me?
You'll try to come back when you fail. You're the only one.
All right. So the parts y'all been waiting on for real, for real, the good part, the fun part, you know, the extra part, like bling, y'all. Yes. Like, I got so much stuff. I need to be doing some kawaii nails, some junk nails to get rid of some of these charms. But yeah, we finna get into like adding the bling and final touch to these nails, y'all. I do gonna say, like, let's not get too rowdy in the comments about these nails be look so cute minus the bling. Because I used to see a lot of people say stuff like that. And I'd be like, you're not wearing these nails. So mind your business. Like, keep it cute and keep just go about your business. Like, it's not that deep for you to be commenting on people's nails that you're not wearing. I would never. I could never. You this, that, and third. And they be saying it in the most rudest way. Like, if, yeah, you can say it in something nice, okay. Yeah, that's good. But the people be saying it in such rude ways. I'd be like, why are you so worried about somebody else's nails in their life? Like, the whole thing about how you do this and that. No. We can all question people that got super, super extreme nails on. Yeah, we can be like, girl, how you do, like, stuff like that. But that's not your business. That's none of your concern. You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, I like to do each nail by itself. Just on my, like, once when you do all five nails, like, putting taco on, the gel be running. Like, once I get through my thumb, if I was to move to another nail, by the time I get through to my pinky, my thumb, the gel would have been messed my shape up. So I take my time and I do one nail at a time, y'all. This isn't real time, this part. I don't know why, but I did want to speed up. I want y'all to enjoy it. Like, some people enjoy this type of stuff. I do. I watch videos like this, especially ones where people talking, music playing, a whole bunch of, you know, combination of all good things. You know what I'm saying? But yeah, for my thumb, I wanted something real, real simple. Just some cuticle bling. I feel like sometimes I overdo it with bling, but sometimes I feel like I don't do enough. Like, I like bling. I love bling. So, of course, you're going to see bling in my sets. Now, for people that don't like it, okay, cool, move on. Like, you don't have to dwell on something that doesn't really concern you or affect you in any way. But, yeah. So, I don't know, like, this, the rhinestones you see on my left were really not rhinestones. They're more like resin thingy majigs, you know, which you put on, like, bleeding out cups and stuff. I don't know why I bought these, but I do want to use them up. I'm thinking about, like, bleeding out me a cup or whatever or something or whatever, you know, doing something cute. But, yeah, I want to use the things that I have, y'all. Seriously, this is the third month of the year. Is it? Depending on when I post this. Currently, it's still February. It's like the 24th or something like that. I think the 24th. Today's the 24th. So, it's 2 months. We're about to be three that I haven't bought anything on this year. You know what I'm saying? So, I'm doing pretty good with myself. I know a lot of brands are coming out with new drops, new things, new everything. Something that I really, really, I want, but I don't really need. But as a content creator, I do need it when I want to do some nail sets. Is I don't have any pastel acrylics at all. I really want to do a pastel set, but I don't want to buy, you know, spend the money because it's not really, I don't need it. But if I want to create the content using pastel nails, then I need to get it. But then I'm like, no. So, yeah, that's, like, the thing that goes in my head. Like, do I need it? Do I want it? I really, like, I want it, but I don't necessarily need it. But for content, it's a necessity. But, like, you know what I'm saying? Like, I want to get the pastel colors from who? I forgot who was it. Whatever. Maybe it was bomb nails. Maybe it was somebody else I was looking at that I seen some cute pastel colors I wanted. So I could do pastel sets. But I was like, no, it's okay. I could just skip that and just do some colors that's really, really light. They can pass off of pastel nails. But, you know, it is what it is. It's not that deep. I used to have pastel colors, if y'all don't know. And you would be a long time. You would have known about Cairo Nail Supply, whatever. And all that good stuff and whatever went down with that. I threw all that bit away. I did not like the quality of the products. I spent my hard-earned money on it, and I realized that I'm not finna fake it. Like, I like something just to sell a product, basically, even though I'm not getting paid to do it. But just to sell a product that I'm a BA for or was a BA for, you know what I'm saying? Things like that. So, yeah, I threw those away. That's my money spent. I would never, like say, oh, yeah, you can go get this, whatever, if I'm not 100% loving it. So, like I said, I only shop 3 brands. Bomb Nails, A76, and Dream Nail Supply. Really, that's basically off of colored acrylics, nudes. Colored acrylics you can get away with, but that's that. Like I said, I did have pastels from her brand, but it wasn't up to my type of top-notch quality that I want. For somebody else, it's probably good for them, but for me personally, I didn't like them. You know, once you're used to certain brands and things that you love and like, you can pick out what's not up to par with you. To somebody else, there might be high quality products, but for me, it's not a perfect fit. I was having trouble using it, and it wasn't a perfect match with the monomer I was using. So I was like, I'm not finna struggle trying to use it. The colors were bomb. I just didn't so like the formula of the products, so to say. But yeah, I really want some pastel colors. Like, I just need like 5 of them, like blue, purple. Like, y'all see the ones in that resin bling case? You see, got the pink, the purple, the blue, the yellow, and the green. Like, pastel colors, that's all I want. But that's neither here nor there. But yeah, we'll see. I might get them, I might not. But more than likely, I will not be getting it. But yeah, I'm standing firm on myself this year of not like buying things, like for real. It's hard, but it's definitely worth it for me, especially since I'm gonna have these products for years, decades, and I ain't gonna be able to put a dent in them for real. Now, I have been putting a dent in my colored acrylics, which I am so proud of myself. Now, nudes, I'm not really big about that because like the nudes gonna get gone. It's really the color of acrylics that be with you for so long. And I'm noticing that the more, that's why I'm doing greens, because I got a lot of greens. The more I'm doing nails, the more I'm trying to include doing colored acrylic. You know, I'm used to, you know, doing probably like one color, one nail. Maybe it's an ombre, like my ring finger, and that's it, and the rest on nude nails. But now I'm getting more into using colored acrylic. It's getting more, you know, detailed with my nails. Now it's time like to get into these gel polishes. Like, I have a lot of gel polishes, like I need to use them more. So it's just like, okay, we getting down to the acrylic, now it's time to move to gel. I really need to work on 3D, some nail art type of things. I'm very terrible at 3D, especially the flowers. That's why y'all don't see me doing them. I do want to work on them, but I just feel like I have to do that off camera and take my time and like really invest into doing it. Like, I've really mastered like the other stuff that I'm used to doing. Now it's time to move on to some harder things like character art and 3D art. You know what I'm saying? But for the most part, for my pinky nail, I decided to do like this cuticle spiral type of thing with the bling. Now, what I wish for my ring finger, I went with a basic route. I did not like my ring finger at all. It's ugly to me. Just the way I placed the bling placement was ugly to me. But that's just me. But overall, my nails still came out bomb, y'all. I'm not gonna lie, my nails came out bomb, for real. I really enjoyed doing these. Like I said, let me know some colors, y'all, of what should I do for my dummy hand. Hopefully by the time I get this video out, I will not have already done my dummy hand. So I'm trying to go ahead. This will be a part 2. So you're gonna see me do my left hand, and the next video you're gonna see me do my right hand, and then I'm trying to see, because I think my sister want her nails done. I might film those. So yeah, and then y'all be seeing some more Sabrina's been taking a break because it's not her time to shine. Okay, it's not her time to shine. And plus, I haven't been thinking about nail sets to do with her yet. But yeah, I'm trying to get on it. I want to do some more spring. Let me know. Like, somebody drop some ideas of what I should do with Brina Nails. I'm thinking I'm finna pull out my, get into my bag of nail art and do, like, some flowers and stuff like that. But, yeah. For the most part, I am just adding some bling on these. So I'm gonna let y'all enjoy this, and I'll be back to say my final goodbyes and all that good stuff.
Please hold my hand as I go down this road. Can't keep going back to what I used to know. But please hold my hand as I go down this road. Can't keep going.
I have come to know the peace that he feels. the past, it's not so bad. Yeah, feel me within, I'm gonna win. Ain't got a question, cause I got you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Cause I got you. Suffered up until he died. Yet here I am just moaning and groaning, complaining. Power is on my side. So this that I'm going through, had to change my thoughts in my head. In my mind, if I thought I would lose, I was wrong. What is fear? I don't know. Rise above it, let's go higher. Spirit overflow, flow, yeah. It's a process, I will get past. It's not so bad, yeah. Feel me within, I'm gonna win. Ain't got a question, yeah. Holy Ghost inside, precious gift from the Lord. Oh, it changed my life. Greater than anything I imagined. Oh, I made it here, yeah, all because, cause I got you. Ooh, ooh, ooh. Yeah, I got you. Ooh, ooh, ooh.
You don't care. Now I'm trying to be in it's just urgent. And it makes us a little change. Got me a war in my mind. Let it go away.
Alright, y'all, so I'm back. This is what I was talking about earlier in the beginning of the video about when I had those little bling things on. I was using this Betticore solid gel thing. And I said it literally works better than my cart. Rhinestone glue. I like it. I will say, y'all, that I feel like this set was missing something. My ring finger threw it off a lot, but at the end I decided to, use these gold butterflies to bring some pop into the nail set. I really think that these brought the nails together so much. I do want to thank y'all so much for, if you stuck to the end of this video. Thank you so much. I also want to say thank you to literally just supporting this long in my journey of doing creating nails and creating content for everyone. Y'all let me know, when's y'all birthday, or if it already passed or whatever. Well, technically no, just drop your birthday. I know Momo's birthday is in March too. Her birthday is a couple days after mine. Who else? I'm trying to think. I also know Barbie's gonna enjoy this set because I think her favorite color is green, if I remember correctly. Like, I remember a lot of stuff about y'all. Like, y'all think I be forgetting y'all, whatever. I know y'all. I know every last one of y'all. So just drop your birthday. I want to see, like, when's everybody's birthday, you know what I'm saying? But yeah, I think these butterflies was a perfect, like, look at my ring. My ring nail came out so beautiful. Not my ring nail. My pinky came out so beautiful, y'all. Like, just look at it. I thought these butterflies was, like, literally the perfect touch to my nails. Like, I'm so in love. It's just, I really wish I would did my ring finger better. But yeah, that's besides the point, y'all. Y'all let me know y'all final thoughts. Do you like them? Then I dropped this. I was like, oh, I'm gonna leave it in just to show y'all the raw uncut version of this video. But yeah, y'all let me know. Do y'all like these nails? Would you wear them? I already know some people feel like it's too much bling. I know. But I personally love bling, so I'm gonna do it. So yeah, thank y'all so much for rocking this far in the video. I love y'all so much. I'm gonna see y'all in my next one for part two. Don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see y'all when I see y'all. Bye.
It's only right that I swing by and hit it too. First base, second base, third base. I'm trying to get you in your birthday. I know these other niggas thirsty, but please never entertain them, cause that would hurt me. You feel me? Yeah. I know you feel me. Oh, I know you feel me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Whoa, whoa. Huh. Girl, I know you feel me. Yeah, yeah, yeah. So much to live for, true, baby. Whoa. Let's not rush into it now. Let's not rush into it. When we get to it, we can give it all that we got.
Me, can't focus on me. Baby, can you focus on me? Me, hands in the soap. How the faucet's running and I keep looking at you.
Don't play with it, don't be the size.